안녕하세요. 농구 이야기 NG 리우입니다. 현지 시간 8월 16일 미국 대 스페인 경기가 펼쳐졌습니다. 2019 FIBA 월드컵 전 각국이 자신들의 기량을 점검하는 자리였는데요. 스페인에도 NBA 출신 선수들이 4명이나 있었기 때문에 미국 대표팀으로서도 쉽지 않은 경기가 예상되었지만 그래도 1쿼터부터 계속해서 리드를 잡으며 90대 81로 스페인을 꺾었습니다. 미국 대표팀에서는 도노반 미첼이 가장 많은 득점인 13점을 넣었는데 적시적소의 돌파와 3점을 고루 터뜨리며 공격을 이끌었습니다. 그 뒤에는 역시나 캠바 워커가 있었는데요. 11득점 8어시스트를 기록해 공격을 조율하는 데 있어 여전히 좋은 모습을 보여줬고 수비에서도 2스틸을 기록하면서 스페인의 공격 흐름을 잘 차단했습니다. 제이슨 테이텀도 벤치에서 나와 식스맨 역할을 톡톡히 했는데요. 비록 슛감은 안 좋았지만 11득점 5리바운드 4어시스트 2스틸 1블록을 기록하며 전반적인 부분에서 팀에 공헌했습니다. 샤프 슈터 크리스 미들턴도 71.4%의 야투율을 기록하며 슛감이 아주 좋았고 3점도 두 방이나 터뜨렸습니다. 하지만 턴오버가 조금 많았다는 게 아쉬웠어요. 스페인 대표팀에서는 토론토 랩터스 우승의 주역인 센터 마크 가솔의 활약이 좋았는데요. 19득점 4리바운드 3어시스트 1스틸 2블록을 기록하며 모든 부분에서 팀을 이끌었고 4쿼터 막판 소나기 3점은 그가 나이가 많음에도 왜 현재 NBA에서 주전 센터로 살아남을 수 있는가를 보여줬습니다. 그리고 NBA 무대에서 뛰고 있는 또 다른 선수인 리키 루비오도 16득점 3리바운드 7어시스트 5스틸을 기록하며 공격에서는 천재 포인트가드의 면모를 보여줬고 수비에서도 미친 존재감을 드러냈습니다. 하지만 슛감을 조금 못 찾는 모습을 보이면서 야투율이 많이 떨어졌습니다. 그럼 경기 하이라이트 함께 감상하시죠.
They'll play 3 exhibition games there, then head to China for the World Cup, which for the U.S. begins on September 1st against the Czech Republic. Gasol taps back, Ricky Rubio gathers Spain with 4 seconds left on the shot clock. It was defense that turned things around for the senior men's national team, the blue team last week. Gasol will take the shot, beats the buzzer.
He has a point guard playing against Rubio in this setting, and throughout this entire USA basketball experience, he's going to be the one on the defensive end as a point guard being able to disrupt. And we know what he can do on the offensive end.
Telling us that some of these players are different in their national team uniform than what you might see on a nightly basis in the NBA. And Rubio is a good example of that, that he cited. He'll be much more aggressive in terms of the shot. U.S. will get on a plane tomorrow night out of L.A. and head to Australia. Turn it over here. Comes Hernan Gomez. Finishes with the left hand.
And man, we talk about Rubio's offense.
Gasol back to Clavert for three off the back rim.
And you talk about passing from Ricky Rubio, and they have a fantastic guy in Marc Gasol from the center spot who also can facilitate.
Quick shot for Donovan Mitchell. Walker guarded by Rubio, gives it up, gets it back. Middleton will take it and knock it down. Chris Middleton.
Because they really lay into you, and there's Rudy shooting that shot, and there's Kyle Kuzma bringing it up. And there's Chris Middleton, he can flat out shoot it.
3 of 3 for Chris Middleton now. He's got the feeling. And you're hearing the pushes for the U.S. Stripped by Clavert, and Rubio has it. Doesn't have numbers. We'll think about the three. He'll try the three and knock it down. Ricky Rubio hits the three.
Coach Popovich called it a good lesson. As Smitty referenced earlier, the FIBA game shorter. Just a 10-minute scrimmage teaches the guys they need to get off to a fast start, and they can't take any game for granted.
Know your Hernan Gomez.
I'm going by the hair. Spinning. You know, this, Willie has a little bit of touch of blonde in his hair.
Joe Harris setting up Turner for the.
He's really shooting it at 47%.
Here's Gill, number 23. He's 31 years of age, second round pick back in 2009, in part because he can do things like down with the rebound for the U.S. Cross court to Tatum now. Jason Tatum cross over, comes up short on the shot, but winds up back in his hands. Here's Lopez, first shot of the night.
If you're ready for the next one.
Dr. Hallahan, the team, the country thanks you for your duties here, and enjoy Australia.
Thank you very much. I'm looking forward to it.
Here's Dr. Lisa Callahan, Matt.
All right, Jared, thanks much. U.S.
high percentage shots, but they destroy Spain on a glass, I think 14-3.
That is right. Plus 11 on rebounds in a quarter. Here's Rebus. Brook Lopez back in, hands off to his Bucks teammate, Chris Middleton. And back out to Jason Tatum. Middleton has it, goes baseline. Sets up Brown for the dunk. Jaylen Brown flying in. Out to Hernan Gomez. Willie is off on the three. Middleton sees Walker ahead of the pack. And an easy two for Kemba Walker. two arguments, right? One is that you want to do it tonight after the game, maybe tomorrow morning, and let the two players who aren't going to be involved definitively get on with the rest of their summer.
If you're Team USA, you had a big comfortable lead, but you're still just up 10, and that definitely can change. You got to keep playing with your principles and understand this Spain team will come back, and Donovan Mitchell would have.
One of just two players on this U.S. roster with senior men's national team experience, Harrison Barnes, is the other. Walker.
Man, he is so good. Qualifying tournament in Puerto Rico has been fantastic and fun. Served on the board, and now I get a chance to call some games with you, Matt. So that means I'm getting old.
I was going to say that doesn't sound like the highlight of that resume necessarily. Keno Cologne for most teams for NBA training camp.
And I think that was a difficult part.
To the decisions a lot of players have made this summer to pass on the World Cup. Tatum knocks down the three. Just over a minute to go. 12-point lead for the U.S. Can't quite shake the Spaniards. Mitchell gets a pick from Turner, glides in and finishes with the right hand. Kuzma. Gasol got a hand in there, and apparently cleanly, as Rubio brings it back for Spain. Rubio will put it up and in. Count the bucket for Ricky Rubio. Shot clock here as Donovan Mitchell handles it for the red, white, and blue. Over to Joe Harris. Turn the corner. Gives it up to Turner.
You want to come in and take away their execution and just methodically grind this one to a bigger lead for Team USA.
Rubio turns the corner to set up Gasol, and that is turned away by Turner. Gasol gets it back. I guess technically property of the Houston Rockets in the NBA. He was a second-round draft pick back in 09, but has consistently decided not to with Real Madrid, Spanish League champs from last season. In his home country, making a good living, playing pro ball.
And I would say for the last, 10 years, you've heard talk about how good he is, and I've witnessed it too. They seek you out in a national play. They're not set strong. You can see they're kind of like in a constant movement. And sometimes it's hard, and that was a beautiful play by
how to teach an illegal screen for these guys. Hernan Gomez defended by Tatum, back out to Rubio though. Yol from deep. Sergio feeling it.
Is that just cliche talk, or have you guys been able to utilize this time and gain some much needed chemistry?
We have used this time to just the chemistry, but you know, it's been we all been enjoying.
They obviously prioritize, and that's defense. And he brings a physical element, which they could use right now, because we got bodies flying all over the place here while Jared was talking to Marcus.
Yeah, get a little physical, and you can see Team USA. You know, Derek Wright has done such a good job, and you look at his great size for a point guard, and his two seasons, he's averaged 8.5 points, 48%. Started a lot of games for the San Antonio Spurs and played well in the playoffs.
Cologne was born in the Principality of Andorra, which is wedged between Spain and France. Population under 80,000, and he was just beaten by Derek White.
Brook Lopez, can you call that one out?
Right, yeah.
Can you say something?
And that's not even a questionable screen.
No,
that's
that
a good NBA
screen.
Yeah. Fernandez for three. Defended it well.
Brook showing his size. Nowhere to go from. Gomez, good job of moving it. Good, this is good basketball.
Right. I thought Brook Lopez had his best defensive season in the NBA last year. Not just blocking shots, although he did that really well, as Fernandez, bottom part of the rim, back comes Spain. Keno Cologne handles. Into the paint, floater is up and good for Keno Cologne. It's an awkward range, shoot a floater. As many of you know, as a point guard, you got to make that decision, right? You turn the corner, you deal with what's there. This is the backcourt most expect to see when the World Cup begins in China. Walker and Donovan Mitchell. Walker knocks down the short little jumper. Kemba is now. Kemba with a screen from Turner. Mitchell for three. Got it. Now with a dozen. He's hit two of three from the great beyond. Fernandez up top. Hernan Gomez over his head. Kemba went all the way to the rim, but couldn't finish the play. Ricky Rubio, really good in that first half. Pretty quiet so far here in the second.
Interesting shot.
It is.
It is.
Camden over to Barnes, to the corner for Harris. Spain great closeout. Scouting report. They're all over Harris. Gets away from him. Here's Ribas to finish it off for Spain. It's been a run here to close the gap. Again, 2-11. Harris caught up in the air there and sends it to White.
Scouting report by Spain. Do not give him an open shot.
Yeah, they find Joe Harris when he finds Juan Hernan Gomez has it. Back to Rubio. Five on the shot clock. Rubio out to Gasol. Here's Yol. Sergio Yol. Here's Gasol guarded by Plumlee in the post. Turned right into Plumlee. No foul call. Rightly so. Just lost the ball. Tatum in the corner now. And it's good.
Man, that kid is good. I mean, Jason Tatum. Game is smooth. Got his feet set. And there's Marc Gasol shooting a three.
Answer from Gasol. Screen from Lopez. They look inside. And the U.S. turns it over. For the 20th time tonight. Gasol for three.
28 seconds left. Spain still playing.
Gasol. Give him 19 on the night. The U.S. can run out the clock.
미국 대표팀이 보완해야 할 부분이라면 아무래도 턴오버를 들 수 있을 것 같은데요. 이번 경기에서는 무려 21개의 턴오버를 범하며 흐름이 끊어지는 모습을 자주 볼 수 있었습니다. 슛감이 좋았기에 망정이지 그렇지 않았다면 오히려 질 수도 있었을 것 같네요. 미국 본토에서 펼쳐지는 친선 경기는 이번 스페인전이 마지막이었고요. 다음 8월 22일과 24일 호주와의 2연전과 8월 26일 캐나다와의 경기는 모두 호주에서 펼쳐질 예정입니다. 다음 경기들도 끝나는 대로 빠르게 소식 전할 수 있도록 하겠습니다. 시청해주셔서 감사하고요. 지금까지 농구 이야기 NG 리우였습니다.